Now we are discussing about rules to draw ray diagram in convex mirror. Now rule one. Now I am taking a convex mirror. This is the pole and this is my principal axis and this is my center of curvature. One beam of light coming parallel to the principal axis. This beam of light incident on the violet surface that I am taking as A point. Now I am joining the A point with the center of curvature. So this is my normal. The angle in between normal and the incident ray, that is called angle of incidence. Angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. So this is my reflected ray. Again, reflected ray extension taking. So this reflected ray extension where intersecting on the principal axis, that is called focal point. So similarly, if you take another beam of light, parallel beam of light, I had already told you, okay, a parallel beam of light you take, that object is at long distance. So u equals to infinity. So this beam of light incident at B position. Again that I am joining the center of curvature. So this is my normal. Again angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. So this is my reflected ray. Angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. So if any parallel beam of light coming, the parallel beam of light diverging from one particular point on the principal focus, on the principal focus or focal point on the principal axis. So if any beam of light coming parallel to the principal axis, that beam of light diverging from a particular point, that particular point is focal point. That focal point is denoted with F. So we are taking as this rule 1. In the rule 1, if parallel beam of light coming, that reflected ray diverging from a focal point. That is rule 1. Now, we are going to rule 2. Now, in this rule 2, if this is one convex mirror, this is the pole, this is the focus. If any beam of light, for example, one beam of light in this angle, it is moving towards focal point. At that time, parallel beam created. That is my rule 2. Again, you take, if this is the center of curvature, you join this. This is normal. This is angle of incidence and this is angle of reflection. So, if any beam of light is moving towards the focal point, it creates parallel beam of light. Parallel beam means its image forming at infinite distance. So we are taking this as rule 2. In the rule 1, if the object is at long distance, parallel beam of light coming. After reflection, reflected rays diverging from the focal point. That is rule 1. In rule 2, if the beam of light is moving towards focal point, it creates parallel beam of light. That is rule 2. Now we are discussing about rule 3. in convex mirror. This is the pole, and this is the focus, and this is the center of curvature. So this is the normal. If any beam of light is coming along the normal, traveling along the normal direction, after reflection, retracing its path. Any beam of light traveling along the normal, after reflection, it is retracing its path. That we are taking as rule 3. Now what happening in the rule 3? Your beam of light is passing from the normal, after reflection, retracing its path. That is our rule 3. These 3 rules we are applying in convex mirror when we are drawing ray diagram.